disciplines. It is that discipline, that skill, that makes you accessible to the spirit of prayer. Enough of this thing that we come for a meeting, you go for a very powerful meeting, and your spirit is energized. And then 2 days later, you are looking for your spirit. You can't pray again. Amen. So we have a lot of brothers, a lot of sisters that can only pray in the meeting, can only pray behind the pulpit. But in our secret place, there is nothing to write about. So the first issue is the skill of discipline. Amen. I will come to that. Praise God. I will round up. Okay? Maybe let me just beat the skill of discipline. Amen. Mark chapter 1 verse 35. Then I will wrap up with the spirit of prayer. Mark chapter 1 verse 35. If I have a reader, that would be good. Mark chapter 1 verse 35. Any translation?
While it was still night, this is Jesus using Jesus as a case study of someone who has built his prayer life, because whether you like it or not, days are coming where your success will be dependent on your prayer life. Are you with me? See, help me tell your neighbor, you can't escape prayer. Whiskey, tell this sister close to you. Eh? Now, tell your neighbors, everybody, say you can't escape prayer. You know, the reason why some of us are yet to be given to prayer is because something tells us that somehow you can find your way around it and escape this thing called prayer. Even if you change from Christianity to Islam today, you will still meet prayer. Yes, it's even 5 times a day, maybe. And then you add fasting, compulsory fasting. That if you miss one, you will pay back. You will carry it over. If you run from Islam to Buddhism, you will meet prayer. Even decide to worship Shango, you will meet prayer. Hallelujah. Except you don't want to, you want to be an atheist, then maybe. But you can't escape prayer. Every religion in the world, they pray. It's a major feature. In fact, the Bible says men ought always to, if you are a human being, there is something that you can't escape. Is what? Talk to me. Prayer. So the better, the earlier you embrace it, eh? And understand how it works, and make progress and begin to like it, the better. So that you are not like that sister who told brother Ebenezer that is Jesus wicked. Say, let's pray long. He said, no, Jesus is not wicked. Maybe you still believe that. Listen, the earlier, see, you cannot escape prayer. I hope that sinks down into our hearts. In case you don't like prayer, just follow these things I'm saying. With time, you begin to enjoy prayer. Eh? Prayer becomes sweet with time. So looking at the life of Jesus, who sustained a heavy, deep prayer life. I read, I think it was in Matthew 14, where the Bible says Jesus drove away the multitude and he went to a solitary place to pray. And he was there afternoon. He was there evening. He was there the night came to meet him. He was there till 3 a.m. And the Bible says when he got up from that prayer, he went to meet his disciples. He was walking on water. There are some miracles you will never see until you enter some depths of prayer. When I counted it was between 12 to 14 hours of prayer. Some lazy Christians say no. Say Jesus doesn't pray long. He just comes out and makes declaration. Say, Father, I thank you because you always hear me. So you also want to join him. Go and make a declaration. Let's see. Great men of prayer, they said powerful public, short public prayers that are powerful are a resultant effect of long private prayers. When you see a man who just comes and makes a declaration in the public and the thing happens, don't copy him. They are resultant effects of what? Talk to me. Long, prolonged prayer in private. So let's look at the prayer life of Jesus, the internal structure. Mark 1:35.
While it was still night, way before dawn, he got up and went out to a secluded spot and prayed.
Jesus got up, went out to a secluded place and did what?
Prayed.
Hallelujah. Now let's discuss. While it was still night, way before long, around what time? Before dawn. Around what time would that be? You say, while it was still night, so it must be from 12 midnight. Three of us. Way before dawn. So it's between 12 and 6. But around what time will that be like? Around 1, 2. The Bible says it was still dark. It was still night. Way before dawn, Jesus got up. Amen. He left his house. He went to a solitary place. You know, from just this one verse, you can see so much in the structure of Jesus' prayer life. The first structure is the principle of waking early. You can't have a successful prayer life without rising up early. You can't. You can't. Do you want to pray around 10 a.m.? People are calling you. Three of us. And if you are married, the Lord help you. The Lord help you. Because by that time, even the children will distract you. Your neighbor will distract you. Three of us. So the only time when people find it difficult to distract one another is between night now, between 10 p.m. Three of us. And 3 a.m. That is the time you can be rest assured that even if your friend calls you, you will ask him or her, wait here. The principle of rising early. Some of you have been wondering, why have you not been able to sustain your prayer time? Today, you've been able to do it. Tomorrow, your boss distracts you. Next tomorrow, something happens. Check it. You are not rising. And I don't know any prayer man, whether in history, that didn't rise up early. Hallelujah. The Bible says, way before dawn, he rose up. And I love how that translation says, he said he got up. Amen. Tell your neighbor, he got up. Some of you, your problem is you can't get up. You want to pray on that bed. Hallelujah. That's why you do Rabba Shalada. 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 Then you wake up after 2 hours feeling as though you prayed for 2 hours. Tell your neighbor it's a lie. Something will always tell you you can pray on that bed. But you and I know where it always ends up. See, one of the greatest forces you will have to contend with if you will succeed in your prayer life is the force of sleep. Every other force, barriers, they are small. The main one is what? Talk to me. Sleep. Sleep. I was showing the mat on which I slept for 6 months before I got my bed. And while I was sleeping on that mat, I felt God was punishing me. Praise God. as a single, and I was looking forward to the days where I'll have my mattress. Then after I got my mattress, I found myself leaving the mattress to go sleep on the floor. There is no true prayerful person that spends time on their bed. The only time you sleep on that bed is when you want to really sleep and rest and relax. Aside that, you can't love your bed and still have a strong prayer. Most prayer warriors I know, some of them sleep on the chair, some sleep on the floor, on the rug. Amen. It's only on few occasions they sleep on their mattress. But you, after 6 months, you need a change of mattress because it has gone easy. You've killed the mat. I'm giving you skills of war, talk to me, of discipline. He got up from his bed, especially if you were not brought up with praying while lying down. Amen. I was brought up praying and pacing. So it's easy for me to pray and what pace. Although I had to learn several other, because sometimes you will go to some places and maybe ministers meeting, and the only option you have is to remain where you are and pray. But that's for a short while. He got up!